A great day to all who are listening this video lecture. The discussing points are how the activities of self, that means a human body and psychological feeling, are interrelated. This is from Vignan Institute of Technology and Science, from AIU department. I am Prasanna. I am dealing the subject of human values and professional ethics. So the topic I am covering here is activities in self, I are interrelated. How? The mainly it is between the power and activity. Both are how interrelated. Here self means a psychological feelings and body means a physical appearance and the physical parts of organization, organs in our body. How the information will exchange from body to self. So I will explain by the slide. The self is conscious in nature while the body is physicochemical in nature. The interaction between I and the body is in the form of exchange of information. So the focus of attention is in two categories of attributes of the self, namely the power and the activity. As the manifest outcomes of these powers are, first, power, the means of the basic capacity in the self. Those are desires, thoughts and expectations. And coming to activities, the activities are here imagining, analyzing and testing. The activities of analyzing means fulfilling our desires with the expectations of happiness. So here the selecting or tasting is the basic level via which the self interacts with the body, that is sensations. Activities in self are related. There are two possible flows of activities, both keep taking the place in our human body. Here the physical needs, wants, some psychological sensations. The flow today is from outside to inside, that is based upon the sensations, thoughts are set and based on these thoughts. For these sensations, the desires are set. This means we are enslaved by the thoughts and sensations. And next, from outside the body to inside, that is the psychological feelings. Here we have the flow of selection, thoughts and desires from outside the body to inside. Self receives sensations from the body tasted eye. For example, our self see a car through the information via eyes. Based on taste, thoughts could be triggered. Example, we start thinking about the car. Based on these thoughts, desires may be set, like when we start thinking about the car, it forms an image that we are leading a good life by using a car. In this way, a good life by having a car becomes a desire. And next is from inside to the outside of the body. Here we have from desires, thoughts and selection, that is in the reverse process. When desire is set, we start forming thoughts about fulfilling this desire with the desire of a good life via car. We start thinking about how to get the car. What is the cost of the car? How can I have that car, etc. Based on this, we make selection to fulfill these thoughts by choosing the car, its shape, color, etc. Then end up by using it. So by together we call these activities as imagination. The activity self are continuous. So first selection leads to thoughts, leads to desire. Then desire leads to thoughts and selection. This is about the continuous process of activities in self are interrelated. And the next topic is Sanyama and Swasthya. Sanyama means the feeling of responsibility in self for nurturing, protection and right utilization of the body. Here it means the appearance, the physical appearance of the body and also the position and the feeling of others on us will be on our character. And swasya means it is a condition of the body where every part of the body is performing expected function. By this it's clear that swasya means a healthy body and sanyama means a pure soul. Okay, and how this sanyama and swasya is related means sanyama means feeling of a responsibility, already we discussed. That means a self-control, or sanyama is the control of the mind and its desires, urges, emotions and delusions. It is controlling the outgoing tendencies of the mind and sense and bringing them back to our self within. Swasthya is the condition of the body where every part of the body is performing its expected function. The word swasthya literally means being and cord to the self being in close harmony with the self. In other words, the swasthya in Sanskrit means self-dependence. Sva means our own. Also embedded in its meaning are health, sound state, comfort and satisfaction. So we can say that sanyama ensures swasthya. With right understanding, self-organized and take care of body properly. With lack of right understanding, I am able to do it, the body becomes unhealthy. With right understanding and right feeling, the body gets favorably affected. For example, when I am happy, the temperature and pressure in the body are normal. When I am angry or tense, then get upset. It means if I am in disharmony, say in anger or stress or despair, it immediately starts affecting the body adversely. There are many diseases of the body that are caused due to disharmony in eye. These are called psychomatic diseases such as asthma, allergies, migraine, diabetes, hypertension. So we can say that sanyama has a strong effect on swasthya. So always be positive, then you will get a good health and a good affection from others. If we feel a negative, then automatically our health conditions and also the feelings from others also are negative. So be happy always. And coming to the relations, the next topic is the relations, the justice in human relationships. Here we have the flow chart about the relationship. The relationship from others to our and our to others depends purely on self. So like that, this flowchart, see here, relationship, self. What we are giving to the others will give the same thing. If it is the fault, then we have to feedback that on the others also. Justice is the recognition of values in relationship, their fulfillment, the right evaluation of fulfillment resulting in mutual happiness. Justice concerns itself with the proper ordering of things and people within a society. There are four elements here: recognition of the values, fulfillment of that values, evaluate the fulfillment of values and mutual happiness. Mutual fulfillment is the hallmark of justice. And justice is essential in all relationships. Justice starts from the family and slowly expands to the world family. The child gets an understanding of justice in the family. With this understanding, he goes out in the society and interacts with the people. So the world's happiness depends purely in the family. If the understanding of justice is ensured in the family, there will be the justice in all the interactions we have in the world at large. If we do not understand the values in relationships, we are governed by our petty prejudice and condition. We may treat people as high or low based on their body, particularly caste or sex or race or tribe, on the basis of wealth, one possesses or belief system that one follows. All this is source of injustice and leads to fragment society, while our natural acceptance is for an undivided society and universal human order. Having explored the harmony in the human beings, we are able to explore the harmony in the family. This enables us to understand the harmony at the level of society and the nature or existence. And this is the way the harmony in our living grows. We slowly get the competence to the living in harmony with all the human beings. So first of all, we should recognize the values or feelings in the relationships. That means we should recognize the other's feelings also. Then we should fulfill by using the right understanding. Here the evaluation means the right understanding. If we giving the suggestions to the others, is we are in the good position, or we are thinking or guiding about others in the right or wrong, then we both are in the mutual happiness. Okay, so this is starts in the family, then it is continuous to the world. So this justice and injustice relates the differentiation in the relationships, that some people maintain the relationship depends upon the three basic categories: the differentiation on the basis of the body, the physical facilities and beliefs. Coming to body here, as the appearance of the body here, gender, like male or female, that is mean by sex, and race, that is the competence, and the age, that means they are in the young age or a child or a old age. Physical strength, it means the appearance and the strength. And second category is physical facilities of the particular person. The person have the good properties, wealth, and also the position of the post. And beliefs means communism, capitalism, and different favorites, all these coming under isms. And sectors means here the categories of cats and all these things. Totally, I'm explaining the slide by the examples. First, respect means accepting individuality and doing the right evaluation. Our basis for respect today is largely quietly contrary to our decisions above. Instead of respect being a basis of similarity or one of right evaluation, we have made it into something on the basis of which we differentiate. By respecting, you mean you are doing something special because you are special or having something special or in some special position. Thus, all of us are running around seeking respect from one another by trying to become something special. Today, we are differentiating in the name of respect. We either differentiate people on the basis of their body, on the basis of their wealth and positions, or on the basis of their beliefs. There are no notion of respect in terms of right evaluation. Thus, there is no real feeling of relationship, only one of differentiation. On the basis of body, sex or gender, we ignore the fact that being a male or female is an attribute of the body and not an attribute at the level of I, and differentiate in giving respect on the basis of gender called male and females. In many countries, people even prefer a male child to a female child, and in some other societies, the other way around. And race. If the person is of the same race as oneself, then we treat them differently. For example, we differentiate on the basis of skin color, white, brown, black, etc., or on the basis of whether the person is of Aryan race, Mongolian race, etc., or on the basis of caste. Again, here we don't do the evaluation on the basis of eye, but on the basis of body. That's why it is physical appearance. And coming to age, we have notions such as one must respect elders. There is no such notion as respect youngsters. Here, we see that we are again evaluating at the level of body. Age is related to the body and not to I. I means here psychological strength. And coming to physical strength, if someone is stronger, we again treat him or her differently. This is again at the level of the body. In fact, we think that we are respecting the others while it is fear. The fear is that if we do not treat them like this, we will be harmed. And next, on the basis of physical facilities, in that first one is wealth. We differentiate the people because some have wealth and others. What we mean as a rich person gets idolized. We don't even bother to find out whether such people are feeling prosperous or if they just have wealth. This way, we are over-evaluating physical facilities first, which are just meant to fulfill the needs of the body. And then on the basis, we are wrongly identifying our relationship. Also on the basis of post. Post, that means the position. We are trying to respect on the basis of person's position. The post is wrongly evaluating is the marks of person's excellence and differentiation sets in. The post is considered important either on the basis it gives more physical facilities or on the basis that certain positions are assumed to be the important. In our education, we are trying to directly or indirectly to earn posts for us to fetch respect. And another category is beliefs. Here, isms. Ism means any belief in term of a thought system that we have or that we have adopted. There are also many modern isms such as capitalism, socialism, communism, etc. The people followed these sets of beliefs are called capitalist, socialist, communist, and so on. The people that have adapted them or are following them have been exposed to them since childhood, believing theirs to be the right belief. However, all beliefs, as we have seen, are at the level of desires, thoughts, and expectations in I. There is no definiteness at the level. And hence, this becomes a cause for differentiation. And next one is sects. People of one sect only consider those with a similar belief system to be their own and worthy of respect. Following a particular tradition or what we call as religion becomes the basis of respect and disrespect in the relationship. So these are the differentiations or disrespects of another person. So all the best students, you should prepare well for your examinations and also for your personal life. Thank you.